Greetings and welcome to the Introduction to Astronomy. One of the things that I like to do in each of my introductory astronomy classes is to begin the class with the astronomy picture of the day from the NASA website that is apod.nasa.gov/apod. And today's picture for July the 22nd of 2020, well, it is titled The Structured Tails of Comet NEOWISE. So what do we see here? Well, once again, we see Comet NEOWISE as it approaches its closest approach to the Earth tomorrow, which won't be very close and is definitely not any idea that it will ever hit the Earth, not going to be near that close. But after that, it will then begin to move away from the Earth, meaning that it will begin to get fainter and fainter. So as it gets away from the Earth and away from the Sun, the comet will begin to fade. And while it's still visible to the naked eye, it will eventually, shortly after that, begin to fade more and more and become just an object visible in binoculars or through a small telescope. So your chance to see it is definitely winding down now if you have not already. It's definitely going to begin to get fainter and fainter, and we'll also begin to see the tails begin to fade as it gets further away from the sun. Now, that is because the tails of a comet and all the structures that we see in a comet are pretty much caused by the sun. So here we see the head of the comet at the lower portion of the image, and then we see two tails stretching back. One going straight away, following a very straight path, is what we call the ion tail. Now, the ion tail is composed of individual atoms and ions, and they are pushed straight back by the solar wind. So they're very light particles, very hard for them to resist the pressure of the solar wind, and they just travel straight back away. So where would the sun be in this image? Well, all you have to do is draw a straight line along that tail, and then that the sun would be down below that, so well down below the bottom of this image. Now you can see within the tail there is also a lot of structure that we see, and that can be caused by a combination of things: how often the ions are expelled. So bits of piece material being expelled off the invisible nucleus of the comet, and when they come out, they could come out at different rates, and it could also be caused by the sun's wind. So once the stellar wind is doing that, the sun's wind, then it would be able to come at different rates and may give you more or less at various different times. And the solar wind is a constantly changing thing as to how strong it is. Now, the other tail that we see is the dust tail, much wider here, and that is composed of much heavier particles. So they are able to better resist the pressure of the sun's light that pushes them back from the sun, and they will fall behind it in its orbit. So they're still continuing to orbit or trying to orbit the sun as they are pushed away. And we do see some structures in there as well, but may be related to the material being released from the comet itself, although we don't have as good of an understanding of what is happening here. Now, these particles that are being left behind are sort of the things that where a meteor will eventually come from. Meteors are generally the debris left behind by comets. We also call those sometimes shooting stars. So that is quite different than a comet. A comet itself will just hang there in the sky and move around as the Earth rotates. So you'll see it rise and set, but it doesn't flash across the sky. Little bits of debris left behind, when they are eventually picked up by the Earth's atmosphere, will become meteors or shooting stars, and those will streak across the sky, disappearing in just a fraction of a second, but glowing very brightly as that little bit of material vaporizes in the Earth's atmosphere. So again, here's your chance to see Comet NEOWISE, which is now beginning to fade, beginning to become fainter, and will begin after tomorrow, begin to be moving away from both the Earth and the Sun, so that process will continue and begin to accelerate. So that was our picture of the day for July the July the 22nd of 2020, it was titled The Structure Tales of Comet NEOWISE. We'll be back again tomorrow for the next picture. So until then, have a great day, everyone, and I will see you in class.